Let me start the session with a prayer. All of you sit comfortably. Gently close your eyes, join your hands together in the Namaskar Mudra. Focus your mind on your breath. Take a couple of deep breaths. धर्मस्या सर्वधर्मस्वरूपिणी अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे प्रयोश्रित्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः नमः श्रीयति राजाय विवेकानन्दसूरये सच्चित्सुखस्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणी ओम शांति शांति शांति। रिलीज योर हैंड्स, जेंटली ओपन योर आईज। सो आई कंग्रेचुलेट एवरीवन फॉर जॉइनिंग Yoga instructor course through Swami Vivekananda Yoga Trust affiliated to S. Vyasa, a deemed university. As you all know, what is yoga? Without knowing, you cannot join as an instructor course. But even though you know what is yoga, we also should know what is not yoga. So let us see today the couple of definitions based on our scriptures, and also what is yoga, what is not yoga. So let me start today's our session with Swami Vivekananda's one of the famous quotation. As Swami Vivekananda Yoga Trust members, and S. Vyasa is nothing but Swami Vivekananda Yoga Anusandhana Samstha. So I would like to take Swami Vivekananda's quotation in the beginning. Swami Vivekananda says, each soul is a potentially divine. We have to manifest that divinity by controlling the nature internally and externally. Do it by work or worship or psychic control or philosophy. By one or more, be free. This is a quotation. So let us analyze this quotation. In the beginning, Swami Vivekananda passed a statement. What is that statement? Each soul is potentially divine. Swami Vivekananda makes it very clearly that each soul, he never said the soul belongs to the human beings or soul belongs to something. No, each soul, it can be a human being, it can be an animal, it can be anything. So each soul is, what is there? Potentially divine. తెలుగులో చెప్తాం కదా మనం అంతా ఏదైనా ఉపన్యాసాలు మొదలు పెట్టేటప్పుడు దివ్యాత్మ స్వరూపుల్లారా అంటారు. దట్స్ వాట్ సేమ్ స్వామి వివేకానంద సేస్ హియర్. ఈచ్ సోల్ ఇస్ అ పొటెన్షియల్లీ డివైన్ ఇస్ అ స్టేట్మెంట్. వాట్ వీ నీడ్ టు డూ, మనలో ఉన్నటువంటి దివ్యత్వాన్ని మనం ప్రకటీకరించాలి. సో స్వామి వివేకానంద సేస్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు మేనిఫెస్ట్ దట్ డివినిటీ. ద డివినిటీ విచ్ ఈస్ దేర్ విత్ ఇన్ అస్ we have to manifest that. The next question comes, how can I manifest? For example, if I say, you all are there in the Manchurial and some of you are there in the Hyderabad. Now we want to bring all of you together in one place. Into the Mudigunda Ashram, maybe. Then we say, all of you are going to come in the Mudigunda Ashram, Swami Vivekananda Ashram. We will be having one day retreat. Immediately, someone from Hyderabad, maybe Anand Rao Garu. Sir, how can I come there? Is he has to come from one place from Hyderabad? Someone else is there, some other place, maybe Manchurial or Karimnagar. And someone else is there in some other place, Adilabad, Godavarikani, Siddipet. And someone is there in the Bangalore also. So each person will ask, how can I come, how can I come? So each person may not use the same transport system. The person who is in Bangalore may come by flight up to Hyderabad. From Hyderabad, he may take the taxi, directly can come to the ashram. Or he may take a train, or he may take the bus, or he may take his own vehicle. And someone else may think, I am a yogi, just I will go by walk. You know where you are. You know what is your goal, then finding out the means is also important and will be very easy. So hence, in everyone's life, what we need to have, the primary thing is a goal. We need to have the goal first. That is the reason in the life skills training programs, in the corporate sector, they will be doing so many seminars about goal setting. To have the goal itself is a seminar. How to set the goal? What is my goal is a seminar, workshop. So Swami Vivekananda makes it very clearly, our goal is to manifest that divinity. So once the goal is very clear, what are the means? Is there only one mean or there are many other means? Then Swami Vivekananda says, you can manifest this divinity by controlling the nature internally and externally. That means you don't become slave to the nature, let nature follow you. It does not mean you destroy the nature. No, Swami Vivekananda never said. You do never destroy the nature, you take care of the nature, but nature should follow you. You should not follow the nature, especially our own nature. Chala mandi em cheptuntam ante, you know, this is my nature. Na swabham intenandi, nenu inka maranu, nenu chinnappu nundi itlane unnanu, nenu ippudu maranu. Daniki oka quotation istam manam. What is the quotation? Mokkai vanganidi manai onguna. అంటే నేను చిన్నప్పటి ఇట్లే ఉన్నా, నేను ఇప్పుడు కూడా ఇట్లే ఉంటాను. అంటే అట్లాంటి వాడికి ఎంత చెప్పినా బూడిదలో వచ్చిన పన్నీర్ లాంటి. సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు కంట్రోల్ దిస్ నేచర్ ఇంటర్నల్ అండ్ ఎక్స్టర్నల్. వండర్ఫుల్. ద నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్, హౌ కెన్ ఐ కంట్రోల్ దిస్ నేచర్ ఇంటర్నల్లీ అండ్ ఎక్స్టర్నల్లీ? వాట్ ఆర్ ద మీన్స్ టు కంట్రోల్ ద నేచర్? Then Swami Vivekananda says, you can control this nature by work. By work means karma yoga. By worship, bhakti yoga. By psychic control, raja yoga. By philosophy, Jnana Yoga. Then he says, do it either by one, and among these four, you can take any one, or you can take more than one. More than one means you can take the two, three, or all. But be free. That is a statement. So either you take the Karma Yoga or Bhakti Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Raja Yoga, any one or more or different combinations. This is the means. Wonderful. Now question comes, one more question. In all the four, you say one is the Karma Yoga, one is Bhakti Yoga, another one is Raja Yoga, other one is Jnana Yoga. In everything, yoga, yoga, yoga is there. What is yoga, first of all? Now comes our topic, concept of yoga. What is yoga? And when we discuss what is yoga, we also should know what is not yoga. Let us look at first what is not yoga. Because in the mindset, we are having some preconceived notions. ఊహించుకుంటాం మనం, మనకు మనకి అనుకునేటివి చాలా ఉంటాయి. ఏంటి అవి? వాట్ ఆర్ దోస్? కపుల్ ఆఫ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్. యు నో ద వన్ హూ ఈస్ హావింగ్ ద లాంగ్ బియర్డ్ అండ్ ద హెయిర్ స్టైల్ షుడ్ బి లైక్ ఎ జటా, హావింగ్ సో మెనీ రుద్రాక్ష మాలాస్ ఆన్ ద హెయిర్ స్టైల్, దట్ పర్సన్ ఈజ్ అ యోగి. ప్రీ కన్సీవ్డ్ ఐడియాస్. అనదర్ పర్సన్, నో హూ విల్ స్లీప్ ఓన్లీ ఆన్ ద ఫ్లోర్ ఎవ్రీ డే is yogi. Who don't eat anything is a yogi. So like this, we are having a different, and some people says, one who does the magic, like a rope trick, one who walks on the rope, and one who do the magics. Siddhi santangara, kondara daggara saamla daggara kotham, swami, maa intlo maa pillalu kitlo undi, maa family atla undi, aa swami em chestadu, notlaka loka lingam risi vale. ఈజ్ అ యోగి. అట్లా రకరకాల ఐడియాస్. ఇంకా మోడర్న్ టైమ్, దిస్ 21st century, పీపుల్ థింక్ యోగా మీన్స్ ఓన్లీ ఆసనాస్. యూ జస్ట్ గూగుల్ మోడర్న్ టైమ్ నేమ్స్ యోగా స్టూడియోస్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ కంట్రీస్, లైక్ జిమ్నాస్టిక్స్ పిక్చర్స్ విల్ బి దేర్ అండర్ ద యోగా. ఐఎమ్ నాట్ సేయింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ యోగా, బట్ దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ కంప్లీట్ యోగా. Asanas are there. Many people think, hey, iroju yoga chesava, means iroju asana lesava ani artham. Daniki yoga chesava antam manam. Asanas is a part of yoga. Yoga is not asanas. Asanas are part of yoga. So atla, what is not yoga is very, very important. And we will see some dress code. Some people, oh, those who are wearing you with this particular dress, oh, that means they are yogis. One who is not married means that is a yogi. One who took the sannyasa is a yogi. These are the preconceived ideas. So please take out all these notions from your mind. We will be studying and we are going to try to understand what exactly yoga means. For that, our scriptures gives one definition. So before going into the definitions, let me bring something. These all are interrelated, interconnected. Mana Bharatiya Samskrutilo, in our Indian culture, we are in the most important thing is Vedas. That is our treasure. Adi mana yokka భండాగారం, ధన భండాగారం, అవి మన వేదాస్. సో దేర్ ఆర్ 4 వేదాస్ ఆర్ దేర్. ఆల్ దీస్ పాయింట్స్ యూ నీడ్ టు నోట్ డౌన్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ సింపుల్ లిజనింగ్, బికాస్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ కమ్స్ ఇన్ యువర్ ఎగ్జామ్ ఆల్సో. అండ్ ఐఎమ్ బ్రింగింగ్ మెనీ థింగ్స్ ఇన్ వన్ ప్లేస్ టు సిస్టమేటికలీ డెవలప్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ ఆల్సో ఐ విల్ ఆల్సో ఆస్క్. ద 4 వేదాస్ ఆర్ ఋగ్వేద, యజుర్వేద, సామవేద అండ్ అథర్వణ వేద. అండ్ సమ్ ప్లేసెస్ సమ్ పీపుల్ ఆల్సో సే అథర్వ వేద. వెదర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అథర్వ వేద ఆర్ అథర్వణ వేద, బోత్ ఆర్ వన్ అండ్ ద సేమ్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఈచ్ వేద ఈజ్ ఫర్దర్ డివైడెడ్ ఇంటు 4 సెక్షన్స్. ఈచ్ వేద ఈజ్ ఫర్దర్ డివైడెడ్ ఇంటు 4 సెక్షన్స్. One is called Mantra Samhita. In the Mantra Samhita, all the mantras will be there. The students of this Vedas, they will be bhajating the mantras. If you see the Veda Patashala, if you go some Veda Patashala, they will be keeping on bhajating, they will be keeping on studying. They may not know the meaning of it, and they may not know where to apply, how to apply. So that is a mantra samhita, mantras portion. Then next comes Brahmanas. Second section is called Brahmanas. This Brahmanas section deals how to use those mantras. How to use the mantras. Example, Dasharatha want to perform Putra Kameshti Homa. So what are the mantras has to be used for the Putra Kameshti? And how to use that Putra Kameshti mantras? So that comes under the Brahmanas. And when you do the Homa and Havan, how many bricks has to be kept? What is the size? What is the shape? What is the direction? And when you go to the temple and you want to do some like a Astotra Shatana Namavali, there is a procedure. And you arrange some specific desire. I want to pass in the exams. So there is a specific mantra, like a Saraswati Devi mantra. Someone will go to the temple. I want to become more rich, more money, more money. So they will give a Lakshmi Devi Upasana. And some person goes with so many difficulties, challenges in the life. So there is a Ganapati. So like that, Brahmanas deals with the different sections. How to use them, where to use them. So rules and regulations, some protocols. That is a Brahmanas. And the third category, Aranyakas. In this Aranyakas, so many Upasana techniques are given. Upasana techniques, or you can also use the another word, meditation techniques. Some thousands and thousands of the meditation techniques are provided in the Aranyakas. Then next comes fourth section, which is called Upanishads. So Upanishads deals with Atmajnanam. Atmajnanam means, who am I? If you observe, so in the Brahmanas and Aranyakas, Brahmanas, you are doing this different rituals, different omas with the specific purpose. That purpose is gaining something which I don't have. That is the one purpose. The second purpose is I want to get rid of something which I don't want. Example I will give. I want to gain some knowledge. I want to get some money. I want to get children. I want to get this. I want to get this. That is the one. This is an example for first one. Gaining something which I don't have. The second thing I said, I want to get rid of something. Example, you know, na chala kastal na yaya. A kastal ani povale. I am having so many difficulties. I want to be free from all these difficulties. I am having the daridra with me. So I want to get rid of this daridra. So I am having the inhale, some pain is there. I want to be get free from this pain. So throughout our life, whatever we are doing, in general, we are doing for only two purpose in the beginning. One is gaining the something which I don't have. Apraptasya praptihi. The second thing, I want to get rid of something. The first one I said in a wrong quotation. The first one is sukha praptihi. The second one is dukkha nivruttihi. I want to gain something. I want to gain something so that I will be happy. Sukha praptihi. Second one, na idoddu adoddu. I want to be free from this. Dukkha nivruttihi. These are the only two things, whatever you do. If you are joined for the yoga instructor program, either for sukha prapti or for dukkha nivrutti. If I am teaching you today, either for sukha prapti or dukkha nivrutti. For me, no dukkha, so I am doing only for sukha prapti. So if I share my knowledge with you, I will be more happy. So this is a sukha prapti. And within these two, if you observe more subtle level, there is only one thing, sukha prapti. When I want to get rid of something, for what purpose? So that I will be happy. So hence there is only one goal, sukha prapti. I want to be happy. Now I ask the question, when you want to be happy? Do you want to be happy today? Or do you want to be happy tomorrow? Or do you want to be happy next week or next month or next year? Choice is given to you when you want to be happy. See, if this chance is given to you, what you ask? I want to be happy all the time. What about the next life? Your next life also, I want to be happy. How can I will be happy? What are the means? That is the Upanishads. So Upanishads deals, I want to be happy. 24/7, today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, next month, next year, next life, by chance, if it is there, I want to be happy. Deenne, the same thing, our scriptures, our rishis are presented in a different terminology called moksha. So if your goal is moksha, if you want to be happy 24/7, Upanishads deals. So from these Vedas, everything comes. Now to understand these Vedas, to study the Vedas, to understand the Vedas, there are Veda Angas are there. Six Veda Angas. Six accelerators to study the Vedas. Vini Vedangalu antam. ఈ వేదాంగాలు గనక మనం బాగా చదువుకున్నట్టయితే వేదాలు మనకి బాగా అర్థం అవుతాయి. ఇట్ ఈస్ లైక్ బిఫోర్ గోయింగ్ టు ద యూనివర్సిటీ, ఇఫ్ యూ కంప్లీట్ యువర్ పీజీ, ఇఫ్ యూ కంప్లీట్ యువర్ డిగ్రీ, ఇఫ్ యూ కంప్లీట్ యువర్ ఇంటర్, ద పిహెచ్డి విల్ బి వెరీ ఈజీ. ఇఫ్ యూ హావ్ నాట్ స్టడీడ్ ఎనీథింగ్ స్ట్రేట్ అవే యూ వాంట్ టు గో టు ద పిహెచ్డి, so it will be difficult, more challenging. Hence Vedangas are given. What are those Vedangas? Shiksha, Kalpa, Nirupta, Chandas, Jyotisham, Vyakaranam. Shiksha, Kalpa, Niruptam, Jyotisham, Chandas, Vyakaranam. Order may be different, cheptunnanu. These are the six. So among these six, శిక్ష మీన్స్ ఫోనెటిక్స్. ఫోనెటిక్స్ ఉచ్చారణ ఎట్లా చేయాలి, ఒక పదాన్ని, ఒక అక్షరాన్ని, ఒక మంత్రాన్ని, దట్ వీ విల్ లెర్న్ ఫ్రమ్ ద శిక్ష. దెన్ నెక్స్ట్ కమ్స్ కల్ప అండ్ వ్యాకరణ. వ్యాకరణ ఇస్ అ గ్రామర్. సో అమాంగ్ దిస్ సిక్స్ థింగ్స్, లెట్ మీ కమ్ డైరెక్ట్లీ టు ద పాయింట్. దెర్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ కాల్డ్ నీరు. Nirupta means etymology. This etymology is very, very important for all the yoga teachers. Vyakarnam is very, very important if you want to study the further. Otherwise, you should be very clear with Nirupta, which is etymology. And etymological meaning, etymology ante, a word is there, how to explain that particular word that is given in the Nirupta. You take a word like yoga. What is yoga? Generally, how can I explain? How can I expand that word yoga? That comes from the Nirupta. This is your first definition in your study material. So this is the background for that. So what is the Nirupta definition, etymological definition? Yujyate anena iti yogaha. This is called etymology. This is comes under Nirukta. This is a general definition. Yujyate anena iti yogaha. that means yuj is the dhatu, a Sanskrit dhatu. In English translation, union or to join. So what is the etymological meaning? Yujyate anena iti yoga means that which unites is called yoga. That means the tool, any tool, the tool which helps us to unite, that tool is yoga. Now I will take the karma as a tool to join myself, to unite myself with the Supreme Self, then it is called karma yoga. If I take the bhakti as a tool to join myself with the Supreme Self, then it is called bhakti yoga. Similarly, jnana yoga, raja yoga, tantra yoga, yantra yoga, mantra yoga, there are many yogas that we will discuss when right time comes. Okay. And these, when I say union, a question comes. Union between whom? Whenever we say union, there should be minimum two things. What are those two things? Minimum two things. So our elders, our rishis, our mahatma says, jivatma and paramatma. Yujyate anena iti yogaha. That which unites, when I use the word unite, there should be minimum two things. Those minimum two things are, one is jivatma, that is myself. Other one is the paramatma, the supreme self. So that which helps us to unite this individual self with the supreme self, that tool is yoga. So now we will, in another 2 minutes, okay, still we are in the time, okay. And this is one way of dealing the things. Now let us go back to the Vedas again one more time. This is the one definition, we will be seeing the more definitions after the break, okay. And before the break, let us go back to the Vedas. As I mentioned, there are 4 Vedas. And so many great Mahatmas, the great Rishis, they have studied the Vedas and they want to present a specific topic to the next generations. Like in modern times, students will study MBBS. First they will study the MBBS. After the MBBS, why that example came in my mind? Because I am seeing the Srinivas Reddy, his daughter is doing the MBBS, so it's why I am taking that example, it came automatically, okay. So after the MBBS, what these students will do? MBBS, one who completed is a doctor, no doubt. Afterward, they want to do the specialization. Someone goes to the ENT, someone goes to the ophthalmologist, only eyes. Someone goes to the only the liver, someone goes to only the kidney. Someone goes to the only the nerves, the specialization. But minimum basic thing is MBBS. After that only, they go to the specialization. Similarly, our Rishi is the minimum MBBS, studying all the Vedas, studying all the Vedangas are completed. Now they want to do some specialization. Not for themselves, they want to present this specialization topic for the next upcoming generations. So one Rishi said, okay, in the Vedas, you know, I felt so nice. I connected with yoga. So I am going to write something about yoga. Other Rishi, hey, I think Sankhya is good for me. So let me do something with Sankhya. Other Rishi, yes, something is there. Let me do something about Vaisheshika. Another Rishi, let me do about the Nyaya. Another Rishi, let me do something about the Purva Mimamsa. Another Rishi, I want to do something for the Uttara Mimamsa. So the specialization they have created, they have presented to us. Here, the specialization word, we will drop, we will bring the new word, Darshanas.